And this is Raul Torres. He's a motor carrier specialist for the Highway Patrol. So my name's, again, Officer Hockman. Just real quick, I've been on for almost 15 years. I currently run a program called Commercial Industry Education Program. So the idea is for us to come out to industry, even the horse industry, for safety. It's all free. The main goal is to make sure that we're doing all these things and know all the regulations properly. We do find it's pretty common to find something not necessarily set up properly. Just the way you were taught, you know, whatever it is, regulations change. And it, like I said, it's pretty common. So the whole goal is safety. Licensing is one of the biggest topics. I like to, we'll talk about it in a group, that way I won't get stabbed in the back behind somebody's truck alone. There's witnesses now. I actually have some brochures if anybody's interested. Probably one of the biggest things that we see is the GVWR. GVWR on any bumper pull trailer, 10,000 or more, you automatically need a Class A license, okay? There's this one extra stipulation for fifth wheels. We're talking about recreational vehicles. You get up to 15,000 GVWR with a restriction on your license, okay? So you still have to do something, but you don't have to go get the full blown Class A license. So the question always comes up is, well, I have a horse trailer, but I have living quarters in it. And it's, you know, 12,000, 13,000 GVWR. Can't I get that same restriction? It has living quarters. Two complete different purposes of those trailers. One of them is recreation. The other one is property carrying, which is, we're talking about the horse trailer, is the primary purpose is property carrying trailer. Just happens to have some living quarters in there. So they're not quite the same. The law doesn't see them as the same. Like I said, I have a really good breakdown that the Highway Patrol put out because there was so much information out, misinformation out there in regards to licensing. And it kind of breaks down all the different licenses and who qualifies for what. So make sure you guys get one of those. Other than that, they'll take you guys through. We'll kind of, like I said, each one individually, if you'd like, we'll go through each one of your rigs, check out the chains, the lights, and that kind of thing, and just kind of go over some of the things we see out there on the road. Any questions, anything anybody has?
Are they not changing it? They're trying to change it, I believe, right?
The law.
We don't know. I have heard that, so it's all up to legislature and stuff like that. I have heard that they were trying to put that in there to where those horse trailers and the living quarters would get that same exemption as those recreational vehicles. But honestly, that we're usually one of the last ones to find out about it. Mm-hmm. But we're not usually at the forefront of, right, of those conversations.
And the bad part about that new law would be the horse trailers get the PTI plate, the recreational trailers do not.
So that's one of the advantages that I always kind of throw out there, you know, just to kind of ease the blow a little bit, is that when you go register your horse trailer, you're paying trailer registration, right? You're paying
$5.
$50 for a couple of years or whatever it is.
$25 for 5 years.
There you go. So when you talk about the recreational trailer, it's like your vehicle, you're paying on the value. So you're talking about a couple hundred, $200-$400 a year versus your $25 for 4 or 5 years. So huge difference.
Only on a living quarter one then? You know, so if you have a bumper pole, let's say, or a gooseneck that is strictly just a horse trailer without living quarters, and it's 12,000, and would you then be exempt to 15,000 still?
Or my living quarter one? I don't know how they're going to write that out. Yeah, I don't know if they're going to make it to where it has to have the living quarters, and that's what qualifies you to get up to the 15,000. I don't know. Like I said, we haven't heard anything. I had Googled it because somebody had mentioned it, and that's how I found out about it. But not the Highway Patrol hasn't said anything about it yet.
The RV endorsement?
Uh-huh.
So what is that entitled?
So it's, it has to be a fifth wheel.
Right.
Okay, hookup. And you get from, so normally any bumper pull 10,000 and up, so actually over 10,000, so not 10,000, but 10,001,
right.
You have to have your Class A. But for the fifth wheel, what they do is they give you from 10,000 up to 15, and you get a restriction. It's called a restriction 41 on your license. So it's just going in and taking a written test, and they add that in restriction on your license, and that allows you to pull a fifth wheel trailer up to 15,000 GVWR
That's through the DMV paperwork.
That's through the DMV paperwork, yeah.
I need to do that.
And I have that, like I said, it's all broken down and what those exemptions are. Is that it? I think we're ready to get started then.